So that's why I'm just giving this overview of what we have discussed earlier. Okay, so first one is hydraulic jam. Because of hydraulic jam, so negative pressure will going to develop. Negative pressure will going to develop on the surface of the downstream side. That is the downstream side off round. Negative pressure will going to develop because of that negative pressure. Failure is possible. Downstream side failure is possible. So that is because of hydraulic jam. This failure is possible. Second type of failure is scoring failure. This is due to high velocities in the flow. That means floods are coming from upstream side to downstream side. In this situation, the velocity of river is more. Eco flotation of velocity of river equation. There is a possible chance of failure of weir. That means surface of weir. So that is scoring failure of during flood. So I'm given everything here, so you can go through it. So two types of failure mainly: failure due to subsurface flow and a failure due to surface flow. So failure due to subsurface flow, two types of failure. First one is piping. This is also called undermining. So this is the figure showing. This is piping failure. So here, the small size, the small grained particles are escaped from this foundation. The grain size stuck on the water particles will carry those grains along with the flow. So this type of failure is piping failure. So this is also called undermining. This figure is showing piping failure. The second one is uplift pressure. Percolating water exerts an upward pressure on the foundation or weir or barrage. This uplift pressure is not counterbalanced by self weight of the structure. It may fail by rupture. So rupture failure takes place in uplift pressure type of failure. The second, first one is the flow is failure is due to subsurface flow. Second one is failure by surface flow. In failure by surface flow, so failure due to hydraulic jam and failure due to scouring during flood. So these are the two main types of failures. So this already we are discussed in our earlier classes. Just showing. So this is failure due to hydraulic jam. I will see what are the remedial measures. So precautions against failure. So what are the precautions we need to take? Only one thing is what we need to do is we need to just a minute. That's all. Hello, sir. Good afternoon, sir. నాకు వన్ వీక్ బ్యాక్ వచ్చినాయి సార్, చేశాను సార్, నేను కంప్లీటెడ్ సార్, బెల్కర్ కూడా టెస్ట్ చేసాను సార్. చేశాను సార్, ఒకసారి మీకు చూపించమంటారా సార్? ఓకే సార్, ఓకే, థ్యాంక్స్. Sorry for the interruption. Right. So precautions against failure. First one is we need to we need to increase the length of impervious layer. So we need to design the impervious layer carefully so that we can reduce the pressure. That is uplift pressure. Next thing is we need to increase the sheet piles. The length of we need to provide sheet piles should be provided on the upstream side and downstream side the impervious flow to increase the length of percolating water. So if we increase the length of flow, so obviously we can able to reduce the energy of water. That means head we can reduce. We can able to reduce the head. So head reduce enough time with that. It cannot take the soil particles along with the flow. That means piping failure we can arrest by providing sheet piles. Okay, next one is we need to increase the thickness of impervious floor so that the weight of floor and the weight of the wear will going to increase. The weight of wear increase ainappudu, so we can counteract the uplift pressure. So we can counteract the uplift pressure by increasing the weight of the structure. Weight of the structure. So these are the few precautions. First one, we need to design carefully the length of impervious floor, and next one is we need to provide sheet piles upstream side and downstream side so that we can increase the length of percolating water. So with this we can reduce the uplift pressure considerably. Next one is we need to increase the thickness of impervious floor at downstream side as well as upstream side. So with this we can increase the gravitational force. We can increase the gravity force. So gravity force increase ainappudu we can counteract the uplift pressure. So these are the three precautions, and we have we need to provide energy dissipator to counteract the negative pressure developing on the downstream side. So we are providing energy dissipators. Because of this we can reduce the negative pressure developing on the downstream side. Next, by providing inverted filters in downstream side, we can even reduce the piping failure. By providing deep foundations like well foundation, we can even reduce the piping failure. So these are the precautions. Once again, I'll explain. We need to design carefully while designing the length of impervious floor. This is the first precaution. Second one is we need to provide sheet piles downstream side and upstream side. Next one is we need to increase the thickness of floor so that we can increase the self weight of the structure. So self weight of the structure will helpful for counterbalance the uplift pressure. Next one, by providing energy dissipators or impact blocks or friction blocks. So with this, we can reduce the energy of the flowing water. So downstream dagara, you provide these energy dissipators, we can able to reduce the energy of the water, flowing water. With this, we can even reduce the negative pressure developing on the downstream. Next one is by providing inverted filters. So inverted, because provision of inverted filters, we can even reduce the piping failure or undermining. So we can reduce the piping failure. Okay, next one is by providing a deep foundation like well foundation. So we can even reduce the piping failure. Okay. So by providing sheet piles, we can increase this figure showing that by providing sheet piles in the upstream side and downstream side, the length of percolation length is increased here. So because of percolation, increasing percolation length, the energy of water coming from upstream to downstream side is decreased. So this is one hydro exam. So these are the energy dissipators at the downstream side. After hydro exam, we need to provide these energy dissipators or frictional blocks or impact blocks. We need to provide. With this, we can even reduce the energy of water at the downstream side. So with that, we can prevent the downstream side impervious floor from the rupture. Okay, we can even avoid the negative pressure. Can reduce the negative pressure developing on the downstream side. So with this, we can reduce the failure, that is failure of downstream side impervious. So this is the use of the impact blocks or frictional blocks. By increasing the thickness of floor, we can even increase the self weight of the structure. So with the self weight of the structure, the upward pressure we can counteract. So after that, we're going to discuss about design of impervious flows. Different theories we have. So three different theories we have. First one is Bly's creep theory and Lane's creep theory and Kochler's theory. In our curriculum, we have Bly's theory as well as Kochler's theory. Lane's theory is not there. So even though we will discuss about the Lane's theory also, so what suggestions is made by Lane's and Bly's and Kochler's, we'll discuss. Is my screen is visible, students? Respond, anyone?
Sir.
So your voice is not clear. Is my voice is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Just a minute, I'm just, yeah. So design of impervious flow for the subsurface flow. So generally, we have discussed two types of failures is possible. First one is due to subsurface flow and second one is due to surface flow. So we're going to, I want to design the impervious flow. So impervious design of impervious flow by using Bly's creep theory as well as Kochler's theory. What we will discuss about these theories first. Design of impervious flow for the subsurface flow. So in subsurface flow, the foundation seepage may cause or harm two ways. First one is piping action or undermining. Second one is uplift. The following damages are two types of failures is possible. By considering these two effects, we need to design the impervious flow. So here end failures man this point failures avakunda em jarante we need to design this impervious flow. So for that, the main important thing is, so that is head. First one is, we know this is the wear. Why this failure is possible? So because of the level difference between the upstream side and downstream side water levels. So because of this level difference, so two tanks, they are connected together. They are connected together by pipe or any other media. The water level in the first tank is this level and another tank is somewhat less. If you see after some time, what will going to happen? The water level in the two tanks will approximately reaches the same level. Why this is happened? Why? Because the head difference between the two tanks, so generally pressure is same. Rendu tanks connect ayinappudu rendu daggara the hydrostatic pressure is same untundi. Hydrostatic law, P is equal to rho gh and formula nunchi pressure is everywhere on the surface of the water is same. They are connected in the surface with okay pressure and same untundi. Okay, rendu levels kuda same vastayi, approximately same vastayi. Here also the same concept, upstream side and downstream side of the weir are connected together to pervious flow undandi. Kinda motta matti untadi kada, matti nunchi emothe water and soil particles nunchi water undi seep avutunnappudu two types of failures possible. First one is piping failure and second one is upstream. So deenni manamu ee flow ayin length ni mana increase chesthe em avutundante the flowing energy. Chudandi ikkada rendu tanks daggara unnayandi, chaala daggara unnayi. Rendu daggara unnappudu em avutundante easy ga thondaraga lift ayyapudu avi oka 1 km distance lo unnayi ankonde, 1 km distance lo unnayi rendu tanks kuda, 1 km distance lo unnayi, they are connected together. Appudu em avutundante first tank lo water level entaithe untundo, second tank lo water level anthu undadu, endante takku untadu, endukante there will be loss of energy. That means the loss of head losses will be there. here two tanks is placed at 10 kilometers away from each other. 10 kilometers duram lo unnai ankonde madhyalo ikkadno energy loss ayipothundi. Energy loss ayipoyin tarvata water will not flow further. Appudu even if they are connected together there will be level difference will be there. Level difference untadi. అవి కనెక్ట్ అయినా కూడా లెవెల్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఉంటుంది. అంటే సర్టన్ పాయింట్ వరకే ఎనర్జీ ఉంటుంది అన్నమాట వాటర్ కి. దట్ విల్ హ్యావ్ సమ్ ఎనర్జీ టు అప్ టు సర్టన్ పాయింట్ సర్టన్ లెవెల్ సర్టన్ లెంత్. సో దట్ వి నీడ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ దట్ సీపేజ్ దట్ ఇస్ క్రీప్ లెంత్ వి నీడ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్. సో దిస్ కాల్డ్ దిస్ లెంత్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ క్రీప్ లెంత్ దట్ వి నీడ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్. సో క్రీప్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ సో ఇట్ ఇస్ డిపెండ్స్ అపాన్ ది హెడ్ ఆర్ హెడ్ డిఫరెన్స్ లెవెల్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ the upstream side as well as the downstream side. So that we need to calculate. By considering that, we need to design these impervious flows. By considering this creep length and this head, we need to design. So for the three theories, whether it is a Bly's creep theory or Lane's creep theory or Koestler's theory, so creep length is the important factor, creep length and head. So by considering these two parameters into consideration, we'll going to design this impervious flow by using Bly's creep theory as well as Lane's creep theory. So first we will see the Bly's creep theory, what he is suggesting. We will see what are the suggestions given by the Bly's for the design of impervious flow. We will see. So before that I'll explain. So this is the impervious flow, this is the head upstream side of the weir, and this will be the downstream side of the weir. Upstream side, and this will be the downstream side. So this is the weir portion. That is the head difference between the upstream side and downstream side is h. Energy available is head is h. So this is the impervious flow. So water is seeping through the foundation from the upstream side to the downstream. So because of this level difference, so let us suppose energy available at the upstream side will be h, energy available downstream side will be zero. Let us say, because here let us suppose there will be no water, that means water is not storing at the downstream side, that means the pressure is not there. Hydrostatic pressure is zero here. Hydrostatic pressure at the upstream side is h. Hydrostatic pressure pressure at is h, and hydrostatic pressure at downstream side is zero. So, if you want to get the hydraulic gradient line, what we need to do is you need to connect these two points. You need to connect these two heads. At the upstream side, the energy available is h. At the downstream side, energy available is zero. Just connect these two points by straight line. So this will be the hydraulic gradient line. This line will represent the hydraulic gradient line. This line will represent the hydraulic gradient line. If you are not providing any sheet piles at the upstream side and downstream side, upstream side gaani downstream side gaani sheet piles provide cheyakapothe, so this will be the hydraulic gradient line. Em chesam first, nenu whatever the head available at the upstream side, that will be h. Head available at the downstream side, that will be zero. Just join these two points. Join these two points. That will represent the by straight line. Join these two points by straight line. That will represent the hydraulic gradient line. So this will be the hydraulic gradient line. If you are not considering the vertical cutoff, that means vertical cutoffs and sheet piles can provide you upstream side and downstream side sheet piles provide shape. This will be the hydraulic gradient line. If you are providing sheet piles at upstream side as well as downstream side, sheet piles will provide this. So this will be the hydraulic gradient line. So this will be the h. Suddenly, because of provision of sheet pile, suddenly pressure drop will be there. Pressure drop will be there. Here also, this is zero. Because of provision of the sheet pile, pressure drop will be there. Just join these two lines. This will be the hydraulic gradient line. This is the Bly's. This is the Bly's subsoil hydraulic gradient line. So Bly's, what are the considerations Bly's will see here? the design of impervious floor or apron is directly depends upon possibilities of percolation in the pervious soil on which the apron is built. Before that, I want to raise this. Yeah, right. So according to Blaise theory, so is given some suggestions to considering the hydraulic gradient line. So generally, normal hydraulic gradient line is this is. So to control to prevention, so precautions we are chosen. We need to provide sheet piles at the upstream side and downstream side to avoid piping failure or uplift pressure failure. So if precaution is going to be covered, for the design, we consider sheet pipes for the design of impervious floors. Blaise consider the sheet piles. So if he consider the sheet piles, so now the length of creep length is increased by provision of sheet piles. So sheet pile provided amala upstream side downstream side sheet pile provided amala the creep seepage path is this is the seepage path. This will be the seepage path. The water and percolate of them. Now the total creep length will be total creep length. Here the total creep length capital L will be equal to small l. But in this case, whatever the length of path, that will be the creep length. But in this case, in Blaise, creep length is equal to. So this is the depth of sheet pile is D1 at upstream side. Depth of sheet pile at downstream side is D2. Now total creep length in Blaise creep theory, total creep length D1. This is D1 and this is also D1. So 2D1 water and it will be able to get it. And the length is D1 plus D1. So 2D1. 2D1 plus small l. So this will be small l plus D2 plus D2. So now total creep length in Blaise theory is 2D1 plus small l plus 2D2. So this is the total creep length, the length of seepage. So total length of seepage here, 2D1. What is D1? D1 is the depth of sheet pile at upstream side. D2 is the depth of sheet pile at downstream side. These sheet piles are provided to increase the seepage length. Student, we are in the subsoil, foundation, the garage is some sheet pile provided. Sheet pile. Here is one sheet pile and here the depth of sheet pile at upstream side is D1, depth of sheet pile at downstream side is D2. Because of this provision of sheet pile, the seepage is flowing like this. Because of this, seepage length is increased as compared to this normal hydraulic gradient line. The Blaise hydraulic gradient line, this will be the Blaise hydraulic gradient. So because of provision of the sheet pile, the pressure drop is created here. Upstream side and downstream side, pressure drop is created. Pressure drop is created. Okay. So we'll see that. So Blaise assume as an application approximation that the hydraulic slope gradient is constant throughout the impervious length of apron. He further assumed that the percolating water, the creep along the constant creep along the constant of the base profile of the apron with the subsoil lossing head. He designed or he designated the length of travel as a creep length. So Blaise is designated as length of travel of percolating length is called a creep length, which is the sum of horizontal as well as the vertical length of creep. So this is the sum of horizontal as well as the vertical length of creep. The horizontal as well as vertical length of creep. So Blaise so creep length L is equal to if you are not providing sheet files are vertical cutoffs, then total creep length will be smaller. Whatever the horizontal length will be there, horizontal length of travel will be the creep length. If you are providing sheet files, then total creep length according to place, total creep length will be equal to 2d1 plus, these are the vertical creep, this is two vertical creeps and this will be the horizontal. This 2d1 plus l plus 2d2, so total creep length. Total creep length will be equal to horizontal creep length as well as the vertical creep length according to place. Okay. This means that calculating the length of creep, the depth everywhere, every cutoff, a vertical drop multiplied with the coefficient. Now, if the head loss or total head loss, loss of head or loss of head per unit length, we want to calculate loss of head per unit length C. So, loss of head is per unit length is denoted by C. So, C is equal to total head divided by loss of head per unit length, total head divided by total length of creep. So, total length of creep. So, if you consider the horizontal creep as well as vertical creep, then loss of head per unit length will be equal to C is equal to H by 2D1 plus small l plus, this is the vertical creep, 2D1, 2D2 is the vertical creep, L1, L is the horizontal. Okay, so this is about the, these are the, what are the considerations in Bliss creep. So Bliss creep is the vertical creep is not horizontal creep considered. ఇది యూజ్ చేసి మనం ఏం చేస్తాం అంటే డిజైన్ యూజ్ చేస్తాం. సో వర్టికల్ లెంత్ ఆఫ్ క్రీప్ క్యాలిక్యులేషన్ కోసం ఇది యూజ్ చేస్తాం. ఈ ఫార్ములా యూజ్ చేసి మనం విల్ గోయింగ్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్. సో యూ కెన్ ఏబుల్ టు క్యాలిక్యులేట్ క్రీప్ పర్ యూనిట్ లెంత్ సి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు హెచ్ బై 2. సో దీంట్లో కొన్ని మళ్ళీ డిజైన్ క్రైటీరియాలు ఏంటంటే సేఫ్టీ అగెనెస్ట్ పైపింగ్. సో సేఫ్టీ అగెనెస్ట్ పైపింగ్ కండిషన్ ఏంటంటే ఎల్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టోటల్ క్రీప్ లెంత్ మస్ట్ బి సాటిస్ఫై దిస్ సి ఇంటూ హెచ్. సి ఈజ్ ద కోఎఫిషియంట్ ఆఫ్ క్రీప్, హెచ్ ఈజ్ ద హెడ్. పైపింగ్ కనుక సేఫ్టీ అగెనెస్ట్ పైపింగ్ కండిషన్ సాటిస్ఫై కావాలంటే, సో అది సేఫ్ కావాలంటే ఈ కండిషన్ సాటిస్ఫై కావాలి. ఎల్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు సీ టు హెచ్ టోటల్ క్రీప్ లెంత్, వాట్ యూఆర్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ టోటల్ క్రీప్ లెంత్ హియర్. సో ఎల్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 2d1 ప్లస్ ఎల్ ప్లస్ 2d2 ఇస్ ఫార్మలైజ్ చేసిన దట్ షుడ్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్, దట్ షుడ్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు ఆర్ గ్రేటర్ దాన్ సీ టు హెచ్. సో హెచ్ ఈస్ ది హెడ్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ అప్స్ట్రీమ్ సైడ్ యాజ్ వెల్ అస్ డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్ సైడ్, లెవెల్ డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ అప్స్ట్రీమ్ సైడ్ అండ్ డౌన్ స్ట్రీమ్. C is the creep coefficient, that is 1 by C. So what is small c? Small c is the loss of head per unit length. So C is equal to H by L. C is equal to H by L. Okay. Yeah, next. Safety against uplift pressure. So uplift pressure safe kavalante. So we have a formula for the calculation of thickness. So uplift pressure is depends upon thickness of floor. Just we are అప్లిఫ్ట్ ప్రెషర్ ని తట్టుకోవాలంటే మనం ఏం చేస్తాం అంటే ప్రికాషన్ ఏం చేసాము, వీ నీడ్ టు ఇంక్రీజ్ ది థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లోర్, థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లోర్ ఇంక్రీజ్ చేసుకోవాలనుకుంటాం. సో థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లోర్ కనుక్కోవడానికి కారణం ఏంటంటే థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లోర్ ప్రొవైడింగ్ ద ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ సేఫ్టీ అగెనెస్ట్ అప్లిఫ్ట్ ప్రెషర్. సో వీ నీడ్ టు డిజైన్ ద థిక్నెస్ మల్టిప్లై విత్ ఫ్యాక్టర్ ఆఫ్ సేఫ్టీ 4/3, 4/3 తో మల్టిప్లై చేయాలి. సో థిక్నెస్ ఆఫ్ ఫ్లోర్ విల్ బి ఈక్వల్ టు, you can calculate from this formula, T is equal to 4/3 small h by rho minus 1. Rho is the density of constructing material, density of material, whether it is concrete at the concrete, steel at the steel, soil at the soil, stone at the stone, of this h by rho minus 1. Okay. What is small h? Small h is the ordinate of hydraulic gradient. Hydraulic gradient ordinate. Rho is the density of material, T is the thickness of flow. Different level. Okay. So now we'll see. So safety against piping is some uplift pressure. Safety against uplift pressure and safety against piping. So for the safety against piping, this condition must be satisfied. And the safety against uplift pressure, we need to use this formula for the calculation of thickness of floor at a different change. Different stages we need to calculate them. Now we'll see what are the limitations. What are the limitations of Bliss theory? Limitations of Bliss theory, we'll see here. Bliss made no deduction between the horizontal and the vertical creep. Effect of horizontal creep as well as vertical creep is considered the same. Bliss method is holds good for horizontal distance between the pile lines, but is greater than the twice there are depth. So Bliss consists of horizontal creep as well as vertical creep ki differentiation em cheyaledu, but the vertical creep effect is more as compared to horizontal creep, but is not considered that. Bliss does not consider that, does not explain the idea of exit gradient, is not explained about the exit gradient, is not explained safety against undermining, cannot simply obtained by considering plot average gradient. Next, Bliss makes no deduction between the outer face as well as the inner face of the sheet pile. Effect of outer face and inner face creep effect is not explained, is not distinguished, differentiated the outer face and inner face sheet pile and the intermediate sheet pile creep effect. Next, loss of head does not take place in the same proportion as a creep line. Loss of head is generally, loss of head is not takes place the same proportion. Head loss will be not proportionately disposed, so that is not considered. Next, Bliss does not specify its absolute necessity providing sheet piles. Sheet pile absolute provision of necessity is not explained properly. Bliss does not explain the specifically explain the providing the sheet pile. So this is about the Bliss creep theory. In the next coming class, we'll discuss about the post loss theory as well as lanes, the lanes weight theory. I'm just recording this session for your reference. Just go through it, students.